Labour's longest-serving Prime Minister.
I tell you what, any boss who sacks anyone for not turning up today is a bum.
For nearly 9 years...
Bring the buggers to order, will you?
Bob Hawke was unashamedly Australia's larrikin in the lodge.
Swears like a trooper?
Oh, yeah.
Forms like a playboy?
I have my moments.
Both celebrated and derided as a beer-drinking womaniser.
Not too much vino or beer.
At the height of his record-breaking popularity, he was known simply as Mr. 75%.
Darling, you only need another 22% to be neck and neck with me.
A Bob Hawke today, behaving in the same manner, would never become Prime Minister.
But those who knew Hawke best say it was a role for which he was always destined. The only Prime Minister born in South Australia, the supremely self-confident Rhodes Scholar notched up a world record at Oxford University. He later joked made him uniquely qualified to lead the nation, sculling a yard glass of ale in just 11 seconds.
I want to go and have a beer. What
about a regular face on the picket lines, his elevation to ACTU president in 1969 thrust his obvious skill and ambition into the spotlight.
Gough Whitlam.
On the road and on the rise, it wasn't uncommon for him to down 20 schooners in a single sitting.
Your parents are both teetotal.
Yeah, well, you can't inherit all the good things.
As his public profile grew...
Do you want to be Prime Minister?
Oh.
It was Hawke's thirst for power that would ultimately prevail.
I tend, I think, occasionally to take too much refuge in having a drink.
A prime-time confessional and self-imposed booze ban helping pave his way into Parliament. Barely 2 years after his rock star-like arrival...
G'day, how are you?
What are you doing in Canberra?
Not your business, really, is it?
He would topple opposition leader Bill Hayden in 1983.
Mr. Hawke, could I ask you whether you feel a little embarrassed tonight at the blood that's on your hands?
You're not improving, are you? I thought you'd make a better start to the year than that. It's a ridiculous question, you know it's ridiculous. I have no blood on my hands.
Unaware of the spill, Prime Minister Malcolm Fraser called a snap election the same afternoon. 31 days later, Bob Hawke was Australia's 23rd Prime Minister, inflicting the biggest ever electoral loss on a sitting Liberal Prime Minister.
I, Robert James Lee Hawke, do swear.
He'd go on to win again and again and again.
You couldn't get a better man if you searched the bloody universe than Bob Hawke.
Despite inheriting a crippling deficit, his government struck an accord between business and workers that led to higher wages, Medicare, and compulsory superannuation.
With the accord, the government and the union started to work together,
floating the dollar, dismantling market protections, and deregulating the banking sector. He encouraged Australians to embrace their northern neighbours, establishing APEC, protecting Kakadu, stopping Tasmania's Franklin Dam, and leading the global fight against mining in Antarctica.
We have taken too much from the earth and given back too little. It's time to say that enough is enough.
Unveiling a new national anthem. And a new national parliament.
The Hawke ministry was the most talented since Federation. I don't think there's been another ministry to come within cooey.
Let's stick together, Australia.
But there were some spectacular campaign stumbles.
By 1990, no Australian child will be living in poverty.
As bicentenary celebrations drew the largest protest since the Vietnam War, Prime Minister Hawke made this pledge on accepting the Burunga Statement from Indigenous elders.
There shall be a treaty.
3 decades on...
Back in 1988, all those talking politicians...
Traditional owners are still waiting.
I guess
In hindsight, perhaps I could have tried harder.
His love of sport endeared him to the public.
We've got to have a bloody win soon, don't we?
And very nearly cost him his sight.
So Tom is very lucky.
And while Friday horse races became a weekly tradition in the Prime Minister's office, it was his spontaneous celebrations when Australia 2 won the 1983 America's Cup,
I get to declare a public holiday.
Yes.
Which cemented his place in Australian folklore.
Very proud of it in one way. Very disappointed that all the other many brilliant things I've said of and never mentioned. What's the most brilliant thing Hawke ever said? It's the bum one.
The Prime Minister of emotional extremes.
You don't cease to be a father.
He wept, denying he'd intervened to have his daughter's drug charge dropped.
I had no contact with the judge or anyone involved in it, and yet you have this insinuation.
And again, in the wake of the Tiananmen Square massacre.
Tanks then ran backwards and forwards over the bodies of the slain until they were reduced to pulp.
Announcing unilaterally that Chinese students studying here could stay.
A senior bureaucrat said to me, Prime Minister, you can't do that. And I said, I've done it.
He led the Commonwealth's fight against apartheid, famously clashing with the British Prime Minister.
We didn't muck around when we had a fight, Margaret and I.
As unemployment spiralled towards its highest level since the Depression,
this is a recession that Australia had to have.
Labor's economic dream team began to fracture. Treasurer Paul Keating challenged for the leadership, lost and moved to the backbench.
I wanted his job and I tried to take it off him.
Revealing their so-called Kirribilli agreement to hand over the leadership after two terms.
I was reluctant to do it because I had profound belief that I would continue to be the one best able to lead this government to victory.
Keating's inevitable second strike marking the end of Hawke's reign.
Are you going to fight on?
Yes.
The first Labor Prime Minister dumped by his own party and not the public.
If this was 11 years ago, I'd be getting pretty thoroughly drunk.
Strangers saying goodbye as he arrived at Government House to resign.
G'day.
G'day, Bob. All the best, mate.
It was an undignified and unedifying exit.
The important thing is what's in our minds and in our hearts.
The former Prime Minister divorcing Hazel, his wife of 39 years, to marry Blanche Dalparget, with whom he'd been having a long-term affair.
My biographer, my wife, the love of my life.
He would be estranged from his family for many years, reconciling before Hazel's public battle with dementia.
True love never goes smoothly. When you're on a good thing, stick to it.
He never lost his passion for politics either. Putting down his beloved cigars and crosswords to stump for the Labor leaders who followed.
In no tacky emotional sense, it has been an enduring love of my life.
That love was mutual.
The wonder of the down underdog, let's hope.
For a leader who never lost a federal election and, even in retirement, never quite knew when to walk away.
It's become a sort of friendly compact between me and the mob.
Hospitalised for what he called the wobbles in May 2018, at Christmas he predicted a Labor victory at the next federal election, but worried he mightn't be alive to see it. An advocate for euthanasia, we know exactly how Hawke should be remembered, because he told us.
I hope they still will think of me as the Bob Hawke that they got to know. A bloke who loved his country and loves Australians, who in the end is essentially a dinky-die Australian.
Australia's oldest living former Prime Minister, Bob Hawke, was 89.